permission of Jhansi Rani Lakshmi Bai as unavoidably to take a Varma Prakara Vikara in order to protect her pride, which is nothing but the pride of the nation and its descendants, dependents and inhabitants. That is her rule, and that was the compulsion of the time for which she took that. So something that comes by tradition, one, something by the initiation of mother like Shivaji and Kapila Devahuti or Kayatu for Prahlada, something comes from Acharya Samartha Ramadasa. So we have to impart these things to the children themselves, number one, the teachers who mold the children, number two, the parents who mold. At least if they start now, the third or fourth generation can produce such possibilities. If you start now, even if you start now, it will take four generations. So that is the purpose of such type of conferences, to define real independence and dependence, and where independence is worse than dependence, and where independence, proper and celebrated dependence, is better than independence. These type of analytical and logistic and logical studies of the real values of independence and dependence we have to take. Let me give you a small brief about this 1857, very much comparable to the situation. I have already told, it has taken a shape in 1857. Even before that, not only the religious reasons behind the Sipahi mutiny, the long felt collective bitterness and opposition within all the people, the peasants, the nobles, lords, businessmen, trade people, everybody, they had a lot of these things. They were not able to make it with a magnanimous outburst. That volcanic eruption could not be made for different reasons. Starting from 1763 to 1856, there were a lot of problems in various areas because of the agricultural and forestry wealth totally that have been misappropriated by the British people, resulting in mass deprivation and also severe rural poverty, which has resulted for the first reason for bitterness. And second thing, taxes have been heavy. Free services have been received that has been sucked from the farmers and poor society. Apart from which, lot of such predicaments have been made by the British colonial rule. And even if you appeal to the courts, it will be dismissed. Blindly it will be dismissed. So at first, when in the year 1856, there was a commission or a department of torture established at Madras, inquiry for torture, at first 1856. Then it went to the House of Commons. House of Commons, the great people, they acknowledged, really the British Empire, the British regime is giving torture to the people. Untold injuries are suffered by the people. It has been acknowledged by them. And Lord Dalhousie, even before that 1855, he made a report that clearly he has mentioned that not only torture is there at Madras, in all British occupied colonies, torture has become a very common, obvious product. So such things has resulted in lot of volcanic eruptions in various regions. One is known as coal uprising, and second is the very famous Sipahi mutiny of 1806. At Vellore there was one Sipahi mutiny at 1806, even before these things. So they could not do anything because of, number one, the communication system of British, it was highly sophisticated. Number two, they are having fireworks, they are having fire machines. Such type of sophisticated machinery was not available with our people, the strugglers and the revolutionaries of our area. Moreover, integrity was not also there. They are all segregated by province, language and other things. They could not do that. That has resulted in lot of other confusions. Already the Sipahis, they were just trembling inside, out of fear, and boiling inside, out of anger, because of, number one, they have been put into very hazardous troubles in wars, like Anglo-Burmese war, then the British-Afghan war and two Punjab wars. Moreover, they are shipped to go to other wars also, like the famous opium wars at China and the war that has been made in 1954 with Russia. These people, they have been packed and they have to be separated from the family and suffer. And at great risk, they have to be working for the British people. And more than that, they have been put into Marwari taxation system at UP, and UP was the only stationed center for most of the soldiers of the Bengal regime. Bengal regime consisted of 140,000 soldiers with 26,000 of administrators from British Navy and Army. And these people, they followed that UP rules, and their residents of UP, their family relatives, kithan kin, they have to suffer this taxation system of 70%. And moreover, the whole nativity was spoiled by an unhealthy competition of British imported products, which has made totally the natural, artistic and aesthetic skill of our nation, with cobblers, starting from cobblers, carpenters, masons, blacksmiths, coppersmiths, goldsmiths, everybody, their status has been reduced to poverty and beggary. So all of this, even the Mughals, the so-called treachery elements, they themselves respected the diversity in the craft industry of our country. These people, they did not. They did the same thing. What is happening now? The farmers are committing suicide. And Reliance, like MNC companies, they are opening, multinational companies are opening lot of farmer-oriented organic products and other things. They are flourishing in one side. So the society is flourishing with MNCs, nourishing the multimillionaires, but perishing the peasants and the farmers of the society. Is it a salubrious, equidistributed society? Is it a society of social justice and equality? The same thing prevails in a different form. The same wine in a different bottle provides love. So likewise, this resulted May 10, 1857 to form a big army to protest against all of those administrators of the British Empire. Then they raided all the treasury, broken of the prisons, and totally attacked all government offices. And whatever they are doing with the public properties now, I'm just comparing. They have done with the British occupied government offices, other thing. Now the revolution is they are attacking public, either by bombing or by strike. It may be ugly, smart, cheap, or better, whatever the methodology of bombing now. What is the cheap bombing? It is not real bombing at all. If you put strike, everybody will suffer. So lot of these non-parliamentary, asabhya, non-parliamentary, and anger provoking and poverty provoking, and that which collapses the social integrity and development, that is also followed now. Then they created a council of administration. The council of administration had 10 members. They did the abolishment of taxes. Now we have to fight for the same thing, abolishment of taxes, not abolishment, proper distribution of taxes. 27th, I am having a lecture on pre-budget discussion. If relaxation in a particular area, don't be thinking that the government is doing some benefit to you. It will be overburdened in some other area. It is known as hidden cost. In a cleverly planned clandestine manner, it will be overburdened in some other section where you will be trapped. The same thing is happening now. Abolishment of taxes, liquidation of jamindars. Now also land mafia is there. I'm just comparing. Same thing prevails. Liquidation of jamindars was done by the court of administration, 1857, May 10. Same thing is now in land mafia. Everybody purchasing hundreds of acres. They are the controllers. They are all the pseudo jamindars or the neo jamindars, the new jamindars of the era. And third thing is to put Indian offices in all offices. Fourth thing, Indians for trade. Where there are Indians of indigenous trade has been affected at all. So these are all the some reforms which they made. And it resulted, you see, now we have to decide. It resulted in the great provocation of anger, that is the wrath of the British, which poured in lot of man and arm power. And this has been helped by two major people. One, the trade union people, who are supported by, who have grown obese by the British policies, they supported British. And the betrayal of some princes from the Marathan and Sikh regions and Rajasthani princes that contributed. You know what Canning told about Lord Sindhya, that is the Sindhya, the ruler of our land, Gwalior? If Sindhya joins the rebels, I'll pack off tomorrow. That much confidence he is having on Sindhya that he will not join. Sindhya did not join. He fully supported British people. Such people, countably 20 or 30 princes, they openly supported the British, and the trade union supported the British, out of which 1857 was totally downtrodden, and the people were trampled inside, and it resulted in May 8, 1858. It resulted in a big massacre. Just it has been observed by Friedrich, a very great critic and writer. He told, nowhere we see in the European and American countries such a rule, brutal rule like this British rule, where violence, massacre, and plundering the public wealth, these things are prohibited by all healthy nations and civilized nations in the world. But these things have become the slogan of the British rule, and it has become a daily practice. So at Awadh itself, 150,000 people were put into massacre. And 1 lakh people, more than 1 lakh people, they were civilians. And a very great Urdu poet, he commented like this: I've been seeing before me today a river of blood. A river of blood. Likewise, that it resulted in 1858. It is very important. Why 1857 is important? You know that? 1857 only is the era, is the particular.